I asked you guys for questions, you did not disappoint. I have a lot to get through. I guess we can conclude at the beginning of this video that becoming an actuary is not a clear process. Who should be an actuary? What kind of person? I'm the kind of person who loves programming. I have so much fun writing code, thinking about how to do things, how to make things more efficient. I have coworkers who will complain for 3 hours they have to write one line of code. I exaggerate, but the point is, there is no one type of person. If you have a team full of like-minded people, homogeneous people, all the same kind of people, you're not gonna have a strong team. If everyone on the team is the kind of person who really likes type A projects but really dislikes type B projects, then you have a team full of people who really just like this. But the truth of the matter is, there are very few things that everyone in the world hates. Like, for me, I will do anything in my power to avoid making a phone call, but I know people who, their first instinct, if they have a question, they will like pick up a phone, call random people, get the answer. It takes all types. But if you want me to give you some underlying base characteristics, you want someone who is hardworking, willing to study long hours, basic communication skills, at least somewhat enjoys math. Why study actuarial science and not simply statistics? My feeling about this is that when you go into an actuarial program, you're with other people who are saying, I want to be an actuary too. So presumably you're going to be around people who are writing exams at the same time, and I feel like I definitely maintained my exam momentum because I was always around classmates and coworkers who were also writing exams. If I was with the stats people and very few of them were writing exams, I think it would be much harder for me to stay motivated. I would say the community aspect is really the one that I would go for. What is the hardest SOA exam? My answer to this, the next one. Whichever one you're studying for now is the hardest one. 2 days before every exam, I was like, that was terrible, this is the worst, I'm gonna fail, it's gonna be awful. You find out you're passed and the process repeats. And then you think, oh, that one wasn't hard, this one is hard. There's no hardest one. Can I still be an actuary if I'm not very good at math? Depends what you mean by not very good at math. If by math you mean mental math, sure. I cannot do multiplication or addition in my head. I am so addicted to my calculator, I'm so addicted to Excel. I don't know how people used to be accountants or actuaries or math people before the calculator. If you're talking about basic logic and reasoning, if you're talking about algebra, if you're talking about, you know, understanding how to calculate the slope of a line, you might want to work on it. Do actuaries use computer science? I personally code in VBA and SAS. I have coworkers who code in R, so yes. Do you think it's a bad idea to take an entry-level job in the pensions field? I wouldn't go so far as to say it's a bad idea. If it's the job you can get, there are transferable skills, there are things you can learn in any job. I wouldn't say seek to be a pension actuary in a time when companies are getting rid of their pensions. Defined benefit pensions are a gem, they are a luxury, and they are not really offered anymore. Most companies are switching to defined contribution, and you don't need as many actuaries when you've got defined contribution. Masters or exams? Depends. Is your goal to do actuarial research? If so, get a master's. If your goal is to be an actuary, exams. Get your exams done early. I would not procrastinate on actuarial exams. Are there any online communities of actuaries that I can talk to? Actuarial Outpost is your best friend. Actuarial Outpost is my go-to actuarial discussion forum. I don't post on there, I'm just one of those people who goes on and reads things. Every exam is gonna have a ton of threads about what the best manual is, people asking questions, people answering questions. That would be my go-to place. How much student debt do you acquire after exams? I can't answer this question because I have never been in debt. I was very lucky. I went to school in Quebec, it cost about $2,000 a semester, and I got about $8,000 in scholarships. So combining my scholarships with the money that I was earning from my internships, I never took out any debt, and then I work for companies that have paid for my exams. I know in the US that is not the situation, but I'm very lucky to graduate in the black. Engineering math versus actuarial math. Actuarial math's just cooler, cause like, we cool. What's the best university to go to for actuarial science? I don't know. I only went to one, and I have made videos saying that I didn't love my experience there, but what it did do is put me in a really good mindset for studying for the exams, for kicking my butt and making me do what I need to do to become an actuary, so it put me in a good place. My criteria for looking for a university was in English, in my city, that's it. If you want to see more actuarial Q&As, please give this video a big thumbs up. Leave your questions or video suggestions in the comments down below, and subscribe to be part of the most awesomest actuarial YouTube channel that you're currently watching right now. Forever. Subscribe. We gonna make actuaries cool, okay? We gonna do it. Thank you for calling. Bye!